Hi, I'm Mike Tomalaris. As host of the Tour de France, which dates back to 1996, I thought I'd seen it all when it comes to watching grueling cycling events. This is the New South Wales town of Merimbula on the south coast. As you can see behind me, it's a tranquil and peaceful setting, which it is. But let me tell you, looks can be deceiving. This is the start of the 2008 Sea to Summit Challenge. Covering 250 kilometres on two wheels is not everybody's idea of fun, but when it involves raising funds for children less fortunate than us, then it's all worthwhile. For an event like this, you need sponsors. You need the financial backing of many organisations, many people. And we'd like to thank Netty. We'd like to thank Carrington, Falls Creek, VeroFit, and Snowy Hydro for their ongoing support.
Redkite doesn't get any government funding, and the work that it does to support families of children with cancer is really important, but we can only do the work if we get support from the community. And we can't do what we do if we don't have people supporting us like this.
And I really liked the way that they had a grassroots approach, and I really struck a chord with the services they provide. And having then met a lot of the employees and the people running the charity itself, for me it was a no-brainer.
Now, you don't have to be a genius to work out that the roads from here to there go in one direction, and that is up, up and up. And at times, the gradients are as steep as 18%.
Yeah. What's going through your mind?
A few nerves, see what happens.
So what I'm doing is going on what they call muscle memory. And I'm really hoping that that's going to pay off.
We wish the riders all the best, all the luck in the world, and we do hope they make it to the finish line. For me, it's an absolute honour to be associated with the 2008 Sea to Summit Challenge.
The Sea to Summit Challenge really started off life as a crazy ride that a bunch of mates decided to organise as a lap around Kosciuszko National Park, which we did for what was then the Malcolm Sargent Cancer Fund for Children and now is Redkite. And we basically looked at a map of New South Wales and tried to find the hardest place we could ride a bike and decided that was Kosciuszko National Park. Logistically, it's a very difficult event to organise and it really relies on corporate sponsors. And certainly this year without our sponsors, there's no way we could have run the event the way we run it. It also relies on volunteers very heavily.
The funds that are raised through Sea to Summit and through all of that work literally pay directly for the financial assistance to families. Councillors in at the end of the phone for families and it's what makes us tick. We like to say that the most important thing about Redkite is that we really focus on the real needs, the absolutely must-haves for people. So, you know, families who go through the cancer experience turns their lives upside down, and we provide everything from direct financial support, so we make sure there's food on the table, petrol in the car for families who are having to travel to hospital, through to emotional support through the social workers we fund in hospitals. And we've got a new range of services as well, support that's out in the community, telephone support, email-based support with professional counselling and support for families that way as well.
And I know that, as a doctor, that kids with chronic diseases and cancer do so much better when they've got the support that they need. They've got emotional support and financial support. They've got a team looking after them, and this is what this is all about.
So this is the section of dirt where we change over to the mountain bikes. This is probably one of the more grueling sections. If you see up around this, there's lots of hills and they look deceiving. The sections of gravel are sort of 2 to 3 kilometre hills with small descents afterwards. Probably about an hour and a half on the mountain bike, then back on the road bike at the end. And you certainly have days on the bike where you're wondering why you're doing it. And really, on the day itself, when you're really in pain, you just think about the kids you're doing it for.
Battling along, but I'm going to get there, I think.
That's good, mate.
It's a harder bit down the road.
You know, this was just after my brother had passed away. He was diagnosed in 2000 with ALL and passed away a couple of years after that. So obviously, hearing about this and Redkite, it's obviously something very close to my heart.
The riders have all just ridden along the top of the plains here and out to the left. as the crow flies probably about 60 k's away, they've seen the snow still on the top of the snowy mountains, which is obviously where we're heading.
How physical it can be on the body, how demanding it can be physically. What about mentally?
Mentally it's really tough, particularly if you find yourself falling off the pace of the peloton and you're really trying to catch up. Although it's not a race, people still climb at their own pace, and when you're spending a good, say, 12 hours out of 14 climbing, a lot of the day can be spent wondering if you're going to get to the top, and if you are, how far behind you're going to be. Mentally it's a really tough day, but if people are prepared, there's wonderful support. We've got magic food. Some of the people say they eat better on this race than they do at home. So
it is joy in a wrap. That's all you need to know.
So you're getting what you wanted out of the day?
Yeah, probably a bit more.
A bit more. That's great.
But it's good.
Yeah.
But I'm just looking at the trees blowing pretty hard, and I'm just thinking, I know we've got the Beloka ranges to go.
This is the dreaded Beloka range. In years past, this has been a section which has really broken a number of riders. Hoping today, with slightly cooler temperatures, it doesn't put the boot in as much as it has in prior years.
Very tough. Just hope I make it.
Yeah. You think you were going to give up there?
No.
Never?
Never give up.
Let's talk specifically about the ride itself. You've done this three times before. How do you prepare yourself mentally, not so much in the months leading up to it, but on the day itself?
I would tell people the way I would approach it, and that is really to do as many miles on hills as you can and put yourself in the position where you really are hurting and it does become mind over body. You've left the beach, you ride through temperate rainforest, then you go through an alpine desert, and then you enter the mountains. And on the last day, you're walking across snowdrifts that are 3 metres deep from the winter we've just had, standing on top of Australia, looking down at Victoria. It's just extraordinary, and it makes all the pain disappear.
The struggle of the last 20 k's, but yeah, it's a big day of riding. So, but yeah, it's worth it for the kids.
Great news, of course, is that we got four riders on the summit for the first time since Cedar Summit Challenge has been running. We've certainly proved it's possible. We got more riders than ever to Charlotte's Pass, and they're all coming up now to get onto the summit, and we'll celebrate reaching the top of Australia.